3, 2, 1.
Beautiful liftoff from our launch site 1 in West Texas. You can follow along as she gains speed in the bottom left corner of your screen. There's the speedometer, altimeter in the middle there. First milestone on her trip to space, max Q. That's when the dynamic pressure on the vehicle is at its maximum, the toughest point in flight for the vehicle. And max Q is confirmed. All right, right about this time in your flight, you know, on ascent, you're going to max at about 3 Gs. We've noted it before, the max G's that you pull as an astronaut on New Shepard actually is on descent. So here on ascent, it's about 3 G's, and it comes on gradually as you go faster and get higher up there. Until, of course, main engine cutoff and separation, and that is when you get to feel those beautiful 0 G's. We're waiting for that here. Next stops, Miko and separation. 100 kilometers, or about 328,000 feet. If you were inside there, Patrick, you will have become an astronaut. And we're just waiting for the two craft to hit their apogee. You'll know they've hit apogee when the speed hits zero in the bottom left corner of your screen. There it is, apogee, just at about 346,000 feet. Of course, we're going to have official stats for you after the flight via Twitter, but so far, so good, Patrick. Looks to be a nominal flight of New Shepard. You see the booster on the right and the capsule on the left. This is when they've begun their descent. As we've seen in the past, obviously the booster is going to beat the capsule down to Earth as it's more better aerodynamically shaped. Mm-hmm. And thank you again, everybody, for joining us live for New Shepard's 15th flight to space. We are 5 minutes into what appears to be so far a nominal flight for New Shepard. We, of course, preceded the launch by what appears to be a perfectly executed astronaut experience rehearsal. While there are no astronauts on board today, that was a critical step towards our march towards first human flight. At this point, the booster is re-entering the atmosphere. It means it's going to have air pressure against which those aerodynamic surfaces Patrick and I were walking you through can push against to guide the rocket back to its landing pad. And to think this rocket will have peaked at almost Mach 4, and it's by the time it touches down, it's just going to touch down at about 8 kilometers per hour or 5 miles per hour. So relatively speaking, a nice soft landing. Critical, as we talked about reusability, the softer the landing, the quicker you can turn it around, right? You're not jostling the rocket, you're not jostling the hardware. You want to be able to flip it around nice and quickly. So there you see the aft fins. We also call them the pie fins because they're shaped like pie wedges. All right, there go the drag brakes. And there you see all the speed bleeding off of the vehicle and waiting for our BE-3 engine to relight. There it goes. Landing gear deployed. Oh, look at that smooth landing. And touchdown. Welcome back, New Shepard.